Let's look at some common examples of resonance. So we'll start with allele type systems, sort of like what we had just left off on. And there are a couple of different examples that we'll see commonly. And one is really with carbons, and it's really just the same as what we saw before. And so there's a resonance form of this that you can draw, where this electron pair is over here and the positive charge is on the opposite side, as we looked at in the previous example. And you can also draw that structure with the positive charge, the carbocation, on the opposite side. You can also do this with an acetate ion, and its allele type, even though it doesn't have the carbon-carbon double bond, now we have a carbon-oxygen double bond. And in this case, instead of a carbocation, we have a negative charge over here. So let's look at the electrons here a little bit. So we have a full octet on each of our oxygens. Sometimes, I've seen students, quite often actually, be wanting to push one of the pair of electrons from the double bond over here. But the problem is that this oxygen already has a full octet, and if we push more electrons over there, we'd have 10 electrons around that oxygen. You can't do that. So what you have to do is you have to take one of the lone pairs from the anion and push those over, which pushes this electron pair out. Now this oxygen that used to be the anion only has two lone pairs left because we used one of them to form the pi bond. And this one that had the pi bond now has three lone pairs. You'll see now that they both still have an octet, 2, 4, 6, 8, 2, 4, 6, 8, and then this one's got the negative charge. So that's a carboxylate is the generic category for that. Carboxylate anion. So that's one type is the allele type systems. As we talked about at the very beginning, you can have conjugated double bonds. And so here I could draw this. This pair of electrons comes over, and this pair goes out onto the end carbon. Okay. And if we do this, the carbon on the right here has more electron density. It's got one extra electron. And this carbon all the way over on the left has lost an electron, so it has less electron density. Now with the conjugated double bond, you could also switch them the opposite direction. And you effectively get the same thing, but your charges are going to be on opposite sides. So we move electrons away from this carbon, so this is the carbon that lost an electron. We move the electron onto this carbon, so this is the one that gained one. So that's an example of resonance with conjugated double bonds. Another example that we can have of resonance are cations that are adjacent to a lone pair. So in this example of an ether with a carbocation next to your oxygen, this lone pair can come over. And shift the positive charge onto oxygen. And the last example that we'll look at today are double bonds with uneven electronegativity. So here we know that oxygen is more electronegative than carbon, so oxygen's pulling electron density towards itself away from carbon. So anytime you have a carbonyl, you have a resonance structure that has a negative charge on oxygen and a positive charge on carbon. And that's going to affect the chemistry, which is coming up in a little while, when we start looking a lot more at the chemistry of carbonyls. This is a really important resonance structure because what it says is that this carbon is going to be an electrophile. So we can do a lot of different reactions with carbonyls that it will react with a nucleophile at that carbon. So now that we know what some common examples of resonance are that we'll see in conjugated systems, let's talk about what makes something a good resonance structure. If we want to look at resonance structures, one, more bonds and fewer charges. More bonds and fewer charges make something more stable. So let's take an example, actually, that we were just talking about in the last session, looking at acetone. There's a resonance structure that you can draw of acetone with a negative charge on oxygen, positive charge on carbon. If I look at the structure on the left, it's neutral. structure on the right is neutral, but there's charge separation. There's two charges. If I look at the molecule on the left, there's one more bond. If I look at the structure on the right, there's one less bond, the pi bond that was broken. So if I have to choose between these two resonance structures, which is the better one, this one's preferred for both of those reasons. It has more bonds and it has fewer charges than the one on the right. Now this is still an important resonance structure. It doesn't mean that it doesn't contribute at all, but the best resonance structure is going to be the one with more bonds and fewer charges. The second rule for what makes good resonance structures is that all atoms except for hydrogen have an octet. So if I want to draw resonance structures here, this is one of the other examples we had just seen. Okay, in this version, this carbon does not have an octet. There are two hydrogens bonded to that carbon and one oxygen bonded to that carbon, which means that it has an empty p orbital. Okay? And because it has that empty orbital, it does not have an octet. Now if I look at this oxygen here, I have one lone pair, and I've got three bonds, two sigma bonds and a pi bond. So this oxygen has a full octet. This carbon, still with two hydrogens, also has an octet. So this is a better resonance structure, because all the atoms aside from hydrogen all have octets. The third rule for drawing good resonance structures is that negative charges should be on the more electronegative atom. So I have an example here where I've got a carbon ion next to a carbonyl. Now I can push this electron pair over and this electron pair up, which puts the negative charge on oxygen to make an enolate. If you remember from before, if you have an alcohol on a vinyl carbon or on an alkene carbon, this would be called an enol. So this is called an enolate. We'll see a lot more chemistry coming up with enolates precisely because this is the more stable version. If I can pull off a proton from here and make a negative charge alpha to a carbonyl, it actually will rearrange into an enolate, and this will be your favored resonance form.